Squared. 9 do-it-yourself energy experiments that prove your thoughts create your reality by Pam Grout. This audiobook includes a supplemental PDF that contains some cool stuff that'll help with the experiments. In it, you'll find written versions of the lab report sheets at the end of each chapter, and you'll also find the game board for the 222 Magical Manifesting Scavenger Hunt. The PDF should be among the files you downloaded when you purchased this audiobook. Author's note on the 10th anniversary edition. I can only shake my head and mutter a word of thanks for it all. Bruce Coburn. Last January, my partner Jim and I painted a big sign, withdrew $1,000 from my checking account, and headed down to our charming little business district to perform what we called reverse panhandling. Our cardboard sign read, "We are fed, housed, and deeply blessed. We need to give." I keep the words "deeply blessed" pinned close to my heart. From the moment I showed up on this fragile zone of earth and sky, I have been bestowed with an embarrassment of riches. Never could I begin to repay all the kindnesses, the blessings, the treasures that have been so freely imparted on this one ordinary human. But holy smokes! After the publication of E-Squared, the outpouring of kudos, invitations, and new friends accelerated into one ginormous, joyous tsunami. Thank you, one and all. From its inception, this book of do-it-yourself spiritual experiments has been a culmination of ideas, conversations, and inspirations, all of which came from outside myself. By sheer providence and good fortune, I was just lucky enough to be the secretary, the scribe who took the time and had the interest to write it all down. Judging by the groundswell of emails, letters, and cards I've received, I'm not the only one whose worldview took a complete 180. E-Squared was the "how you doing" moment for a whole tribe of spiritual researchers who began to realize that picking up the do doesn't need to take enormous effort and countless years. Maybe for the first time it registered that what we see out there is not the deepest reality, and that maybe there is a more magical way of existing in the world. As I read over the manuscript to update and refresh some of the cultural references for this new edition, I was dumbfounded at how relevant and inspiring it still is today. I found myself high-fiving Jim, cha-chaing down the hallway, and remarking, okay, I was bragging, to my possibility posse, "This book is really good. No wonder it became such an international sensation." They looked at me blankly and said, "Well, duh." It isn't that I'm a particularly gifted writer. As I said before, I view myself as a staunchly loyal satellite dish. It's that E-Squared emboldened others to write their own book of spiritual experimentation. It enticed them to take out for a spin the principles they've been reading about since Gutenberg published that first 42-line Latin Bible. It's one thing to read about a big kahuna who allegedly loves you, but until you actually experience its presence in real time, until you actually use it to better your life, it does little but provoke guilt. Dang it, why didn't I think to ask the big guy for guidance? E-Squared doesn't ask readers to believe a single thing. It just gently suggests that maybe there's a loving energy force that has their best interests at heart, and that maybe their thoughts and beliefs might, you know, interact with this invisible field. And that maybe, instead of taking other people's word for such loaded concepts as God or love or even spirituality, they ought to test it out for themselves. Most people, it seems, orient their lives and worldview around other people's opinions. They're given a formula that goes something like this. Get an education, get a guy or gal, collect some stuff, collect more stuff, keep your eye on the other to make sure he or she isn't getting more than you. They're so busy impersonating who they think they're supposed to be that they never stop to ask themselves, what do I believe? What do I know to be true? E-Square pulls no punches. You, dear listener, are the sole and final authority on who you are and what is possible. This book asks you to trust nothing but your own direct experience. As for everybody else, they can mind their own damn business. If anything, the experiments in this book are a sly bait and switch to inspire readers to pay attention to a different, truer, more beautiful reality. My ploy seems to have worked. Most of the 250,000 messages I've received from readers start with some rendition of, OMG, you are never going to believe this. I usually just nod my head and think, well, duh. It's a popular phrase for those of us who understand how powerfully consciousness shapes and molds reality. Even now, nary a week goes by without at least one email from some new reader. I once joked it was like having my own personal self-help channel. Any residual of skepticism I might have once harbored has officially been obliterated. The stories that land in my inbox would knock doubt from the most fervent of cynics. Here's a delightful one that recently made landfall. This particular reader made the intention to swim with dolphins. Fun idea, right? Connecting with nature, hanging out at a beach. As a travel writer, I know from personal experience that lots of resorts throughout the world offer just such an opportunity. But according to the parameters of E-squared, this researcher had a mere 48 hours to make her intentions a reality. Plus, she was camping with her family, nowhere near anything that resembled a resort. However, there was a deserted strip of sand a short walk from the campground. She ambled down there one day, and near the rock face on one end, she noticed six black fins. Voila, she thought, ready to dive in and join them. But alas, the dolphins turned tail and swam away. Nevertheless, she felt invigorated and excited and grateful. I mean, just seeing dolphins is pretty cool, right? She was walking back to the campground when she heard a voice of startling clarity. Yes, there is a voice that constantly tries to make contact once we claw our way out of the societal coma we believe to be reality. The voice clearly instructed, "They're back for you." She turned around, and sure enough, 40 dolphins were cruising near the shore. She stripped down, jumped in, and swam for 20 minutes, the resorts barely give you five, not just with the original 40 dolphins, but with several other dolphin pods that converged from all directions. Oh, and did I mention this was 2 hours before the 48-hour deadline? I love these reminders that behind the scenes, even when we're not aware of it, miracles and blessings are being orchestrated on our behalf. To be the one to field all these ridiculously awesome miracle tales has been extraordinarily edifying. And because, like my sign said, I have the need to give, I have been freely sharing my toys, my tales, with others, on my blog and in 4 follow-up books. It's my intention to continue creating a resonant field of excitement and possibility. Someone described E-squared as the secret on crack, which I took as a compliment, but I also want to make clear that material bennies have never been the point. Sure, we need to master our built-in superpower to influence reality, but only so we can take our minds off scarcity, separation, and material worries, all of which are the polar opposite of reality at its core. We're releasing this anniversary edition of E-squared as a refresher course. Never has it been more relevant for us humans to understand the universal energy field that forms itself around our thoughts and beliefs. Never has it been more important to realize how profoundly we are all connected. In addition to the 9 experiments, this 10-year anniversary edition offers a 222 magical manifesting scavenger hunt, complete with a game board, which you'll find in the PDF of supplemental materials that came with this audiobook, giving you yet another opportunity to prove the world is nothing like advertised. Playing a daily manifesting game with the universe is one more tool for your quiver, one more piece of evidence that miracles do indeed happen on a daily basis. Scientists at Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute recently published a paper stating that it takes but 10% of a population to create a tipping point, which means that a very small number of impassioned people who understand the invisible energy realm that influences the material realm can play a pivotal role in the upliftment of planetary consciousness. If we work together, we can be the pioneers who call forth a brand new world. And since, spoiler alert, it's a foregone conclusion we'll all eventually melt back into love and light anyway, we might as well get this show on the road. Have fun, be dazzled, and know that I love you to the dust tail of Halley's Comet and back. 222 forever.
Foreword. When I was a kid, I asked my Sunday school teacher why miracles occurred in biblical times but didn't seem to be a part of our lives today. She had no answer. And I gradually came to assume that God, church, and religious stuff were irrelevant and far removed from my own life, even though I never quit longing for something more. I left spirituality behind to pursue science, which at least made an attempt to explain how the world works. It's a real treat to find Pam Grout's writings, which help doubters like me fill that desire for spirituality. She presents, in a delightful, fun way, at a level anyone can understand, that energy, power, and yes, even miracles are here now and available to everyone. The ideas and experiments in this book have helped me grasp, in language that makes sense, many of the things spiritual guides have been teaching for thousands of years. I highly recommend this book to anyone who is seeking to understand spiritual ideas and how they.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.